Indian government's largest ever asset sale, and any buyer who's interested in buying Air India will have to pay up at least 9,500 crore for 76% stake in the airline. That's according to SBI Capital. Soumeet is standing by. Will tell us how the broking firm has come up with that number. Soumeet.
So I'll start off with the enterprise value first. Now, if you see, the brokerage is expecting the financial year 2019 EBITDA, that is earnings before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization and rental costs, also known as the operational profit for an airline company, to be close to at around 7,630 crore rupees. At this, they are multiplying it with a multiple of around 7 times, that is EV to EBITDA of 7 times. Why 7 times? Because this is what the nearest listed competitor, that is Jet Airways, is valued at, and also other global full service airline companies are valued at. So this gives us an enterprise value of close to 53,400 crore rupees. Now, in this part, the expected operational turnaround by the potential buyer is important, because that is what will give value to Air India's equity. Now, considering the same valuation multiple and FY17 EBITDA, which is close to 4,600 crore rupees, the equity value of Air India is negative. So that's the reason this operational turnaround is important. So now at 53,400 enterprise value, let's see how the equity value comes out. Now at this enterprise value, the brokerage has deducted the net debt of 24,576 crore rupees. Now Air India will have a debt of close to 33,000 crore rupees, but of that, only this amount is the long-term debt. So that has to be deducted. Along with that, the brokerage has also deducted the lease rent that it has capitalized. Now the divestment also includes 50% stake in the ground handling unit, that is AISAT. So they are valuing it at around 660 crore rupees. Now, along with this, SBI Cap has also added close to 5,700 crore rupees as present value of unabsorbed depreciation. Now, I'll explain this later. So this gives us an equity value of close to 12,500 crore rupees, of which 76% will be valued at 9,469 crore rupees. Now, two important points in this. First, on the debt. Now, though Air India will have a huge debt of 33,000 crore rupees. Now, why I'm saying it is huge? Because the three listed airline companies, that is Jet Airways, IndiGo and SpiceJet, have less than half the debt of that of Air India. So that's the reason it's a very huge debt. But this might not be a concern for the buyer, because nearly 50% of its debt is backed by its assets, that is the 86 owned aircrafts. Now Air India has around 54 aircrafts on financial lease, while it owns 32 aircrafts, which is valued at close to 15,183 crore rupees. So this might not be a big concern for the potential buyer. Now secondly, the unabsorbed depreciation. Now what is unabsorbed depreciation? It is the unclaimed expenditure from the previous profit and loss account, because this cannot be claimed because of lack of sufficient income. Now this unabsorbed depreciation of close to 31,806 crore rupees can be set off against Air India's profit. So whenever Air India makes profits in futures, the company will not have to pay taxes to the tune of close to 9,500 crore rupees. That is, we are assuming a 30% tax rate, because it can claim the unabsorbed depreciation against the profits. Now this 9,500 crore rupees will be spread spread over years, and will not happen in 1 year. And that's the reason SBI Cap had given a present value of close to 5,700 crore rupees for this tax benefit that the potential buyer will get in future years.